Heterotrophic mode of nutrition in plants. We know that green plants have chlorophyll, but there are some plants which do not have chlorophyll, so they cannot synthesize their food. Now, you will wonder, how do such plants survive? We know that heterotrophs, namely humans and animals, depend on plants for their food. Similarly, plants without chlorophyll also depend on food produced by other plants. This is called the heterotrophic mode of nutrition in plants. For example, cascada plant, also called amarbel. Since this plant does not have chlorophyll, it climbs onto another plant and takes the ready-made food from it. The plant on which it climbs is called the host. So, we can say that the organism whose essential nutrients are deprived by another organism, such as a parasite, is called a host. Since this plant deprives the host of its valuable nutrients, it is called a parasite. The organism which obtains nutrients from another organism by depriving it of its essential nutrients is called a parasite. Note that although humans and animals depend on plants for their food, they are not parasites. This is because they do not deprive the plants of their essential nutrients. However, mosquitoes, bedbugs, lice and leeches are parasites because they suck human blood and depend on them for their food. Some green plants like Drosera, Venus flytrap, etc. are unable to obtain all the nutrients required to prepare their food from the soil or their surroundings. In such cases, these plants develop features which help them survive. They can trap insects and digest them. Plants which trap and feed on insects are called insectivorous plants. For example, pitcher plant. Let us study the parts of this plant. The leaf of this plant is modified in the shape of a pitcher. The apex of the leaf forms the lid. The function of the lid is to open and close the mouth of the pitcher. Inside the pitcher, there are hairs which are directed downwards. Now let us see how this plant traps insects. When an insect lands in the pitcher, its lid closes. Thus, the insect gets trapped and entangled in the hair. The pitcher plant digests the trapped insect by secreting digestive juices. Thus, insectivorous plants are partial heterotrophs. These plants, also called insect-eating plants, grow in soil containing less nutrients. So, they feed on animals like insects to fulfill their nutrient requirement.